You know, the way we conduct conservation evolved over time. In the long past, and I'm sorry if I can use this term, during colonial time, there's what they used to say, it was sticks and fines, okay? You break the law, you were found inside the park, then it was hard time for you. So really these people didn't see, and they felt that management authorities were just benefiting and they had nothing to benefit from it. And so really, and for some families, of course, some of them were displaced and they still had that memory that it used to be our land, now it has been taken over. But then gradually it evolved that, you know, rather than playing with law enforcement only, these people need to be educated because the value of conservation is there. And it's not for the for the management authorities only. No, it's for the entire nation, and everybody has to benefit from the resources which are endowed in the country. So it gradually evolved, starting with, let's help with maybe building roads for them, talking to them, having some programs together. And, as we moved on in the 90s, bring them into the park, have some activities, dancing for the tourists. And, that improved their livelihood. And of course, they appreciated that they also have something to gain from them.